Hey YouTubers, it's Optimus Smythe coming at you here with another video review of movie Landmine, Deluxe Landmine. Yeah, he wasn't in the movie, and he's not going to be in Revenge of the Fallen, actually. He's supposed to be like a drone character. He was in the comics, I think, used by Sector 7, hence all the S7s all over it. Although, I just broke something off a little. Although, the vehicles that the army used at the end when they were in Mission City looked just like this, only there were a bunch of them, and they didn't transform either. I don't know why it says Sector 7, the logo. It should say, like, well, because it wasn't used by Sector 7, so I don't know why it's like that. But, yeah, I just got this because he looked really cool, and he is pretty cool, too. Landmine's a cool character. He's a little, like, Jeepish dune bug type thing that they use in the army. You can see the gun up here. Yeah, and if you look in here, it's actually pretty realistic. Inside what are going to be the hands form the seats, and if you look closely, there's, like, kind of like a step up here where somebody will go up, and that circular thing that I'm pointing to, this is where somebody stands, and they use this gun. It's got two handles right here, and the gun can move up and down and can swivel around. Or it can be taken off if you don't like it. That's what he'd look like with it off. And the vehicle is like a dark, like, cyan. And it's got the silvery gray everywhere. Black for the wheels. Yeah, the wheels have suspension. You can push them up and down, but it's not that good. That doesn't work terrifically. But, oh well. They do have springs in them, so super suspension wheels. It's pretty cool. Yeah, and the paint job with the logos and things is a lot better than it was with, like, Movie Barricade. And right here is the Autobot logo, really nicely done. Yeah, and it's pretty cool. Yeah, that's all I have to say about the vehicle mode. Now let's transform him. Oh, but I forgot to give my rating. 10 out of 10. There's nothing wrong with it. It doesn't really excite me too much, but it is a sweet little army vehicle. Okay, now to transform him. Let's see, what I would do first is try and detach the whole back of it from the roof, like that, and then just bend it back. Those are going to be his legs, but let's worry about that later. Now let's take the arms out, and when you do take them out, yeah, the wheels will sink in. There's a spring right in there that'll keep them in. Bend the arms out, and along with the hands. Put the arms however you want, and to get those fingers out, that's the thumb, I guess, to get the finger out. This is hard to do. They're rubbery, so it's not that hard to do. All you gotta do is try pulling it out, like that. So there we go. And then just put them down. Let me do the other one real quick. Oh, that was quicker. And now, what you want to do next is push down the whole front of the vehicle with the wheels, and it should, let's see if I got it right, yep, it should snap in right like that. And this thing behind him, I put it back like that instead of forward, because for some reason when I do it bends off, so yeah, and it comes off like that. So I put it back, and there's his head. You just put his head down, and let's move his arms up a little so they don't get in the way. Now for the legs, this is easy. Just pull them apart, take the wheel and push it in, and then that'll allow it to go down and it clicks into place. They don't always stay in that well though, so push it in, put it down, and then swivel these tank things down like that, because those are his feet. Yeah. So here he is, he's pretty much done. Now to put his weapon in his hand can be kind of tricky. It doesn't have a hole in it, but his hand is pretty much, it can open and closed, so you just put it in like this, and then close it up as best you can. So there we go. He's got his awesome little gun. I really like the way how they designed his gun. It looks really interesting. So here he is. We can see a couple new colors, that cyan blue, sky blue color underneath his head. He's got a really strange head. He's got it's all blue underneath with, like, four eyes, and then this, like, cage is on top of it, if you look closely. Kind of strange looking. Yeah, and, The rest of the paint job has kind of remained the same, but I did forget to mention that there's yellow and red on the rear lights down here, which are now his kneecaps. Yeah, he is pretty poseable too. Everything is pretty much ball and socketed, except for at his knees and down at his feet. His feet can bend back and forth though like that, so it makes him pretty poseable. And he could run pretty fast too, because he's got wheels on his feet, so that would help. Yeah, a really interesting figure. Really nice looking. The posability is excellent. Not very limited. There's nothing really wrong with him, except for that these wheels tend to go back like that when I set him up, so it can be hard to set him up. But he is pretty posable. Nothing wrong with him, really. Not the best figure of all, but it's probably worth having. Especially if you like the movie figures that they make. This gun can be kind of hard to situate sometimes. So, yeah, here comes my cat. Yeah, okay. Anyways, so I guess that's it. Kind of a short review, but it's a nice figure. You should go buy him if you like it. So, his rating, I'll give him a 10 out of 10. He's not perfect, but there's not really anything wrong with him. He's just kind of floppy down there, but nothing else is really wrong. Yeah, so that's all I have to say. That's Movie Landmine. Optimus Smythe signing off.